And we start with the new details we're learning about the firing of a popular principal at McAuliffe International School here in Denver.
Former principal Kurt Dennis was investigated by the school board for going public about security issues and for seeing what a whistleblower called a seclusion room against DPS policy. Fox 31's Vicente Arenas joins us live with what a board member is saying and how Dennis's attorney is firing back. Vicente.
Yeah, we heard some of those new details today, and it all came from this so-called conclusion letter that was first made public last week by Kurt Dennis's attorney. In this letter, it outlines some of the allegations about the seclusion room and some of the findings.
Today, DPS School Board Vice President Ayante Anderson spoke publicly about that letter that was sent to Principal Kurt Dennis. Fox 31 obtained a copy of that letter today from Dennis's attorney. The letter said there were three student complaints about the seclusion room, and they were identified. Another student was impacted. Board Member Anderson says four students of color were placed in the room with a door that locked from the outside. He also said the letter pointed out that Dennis declined to participate in the investigation and that Dennis directed staff to place students in the rooms without proper supervision and that two rooms were allegedly used.
Well, I think first and foremost is that we did know that there were not one seclusion rooms, but two seclusion rooms at this campus. We do know that a leader who was a well-established leader in our community and in our district and is well knowledgeable of our district policies placed students in this room multiple times.
Today, Kurt Dennis's attorney said Anderson was misinforming the public. David Lane said that a de-escalation room was used, not a seclusion room. Lane said at times Dennis would leave the room if he was being attacked and the door would be shut and that the student would then be monitored. Lane said Dennis cooperated fully with investigators.
Kurt Dennis, I have a written document prepared by DPS where when he talked to the media, they said, we're going to investigate you. Kurt Dennis responded to every single question asked by the DPS investigator. I have the document. So when he says he wouldn't cooperate, that is just an abject lie.
Today, Ayante Anderson also mentioned a 33-page report that has not been made public. In that report, he says there are a lot more details about this investigation that he would at some point like the public to know, but so far that's not happening. David Lane, Kurt Dennis's attorney, says he'd like to see that document too. As a matter of fact, he's tried to get it from the district twice, but twice he's been told no. This case now is expected to go to federal court next week. Live outside DPS headquarters, downtown Denver, Vicente Adams, Fox 31.